Everyone says you need to use a lot of marketing tools to do well on Google. You're probably using 5, 10, 20 tools, but you know what? You don't need all those tools to do well. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna share with you the only 3 tools you need to rank number 1 on Google. Before I get started and showcase these 3 tools for you, make sure you subscribe and follow me. Whatever social platform you're watching this video on, subscribe, because each week I'm gonna be bringing you new marketing knowledge. The first tool that you need to use is Ubersuggest. How many of you guys have heard of Ubersuggest? If you have, just leave a comment saying yes. It's a free marketing tool that I release for you. Yes, that's right, you don't have to pay for it. The way Ubersuggest works is you can take all the keywords that you're already ranking number 1 for, or number 2 for, or even on page 1 for, and put those keywords into Ubersuggest. Ubersuggest will show you all the long tail variations of that keyword. Because check this out, already ranking on Google for a specific term, it's really easy for you to rank for also the long tail variations of that term. For example, if you typed in the keyword digital marketing into Ubersuggest, you'll see tons of other variations. It could be about digital marketing companies, digital marketing jobs, digital marketing consultant, whatever the list may be. If you already rank for that head term, using Ubersuggest will give you a laundry list of hundreds and hundreds of other long tail phrases that you can mix into your content and just instantly grow your traffic. When you do this and you update your content, all it takes is roughly 30 days before you start ranking for a lot of those long tail key phrases as well. But the key isn't not to just add those keywords into your content, you have to adjust your text, in which you can't just add digital marketing jobs onto a page that's talking about digital marketing. You may have to add a few paragraphs around digital marketing jobs. And you need to blend it in. If it's not natural, don't just add the keywords because you're looking for that extra traffic. But using Ubersuggest, it'll tell you how to get extra traffic by just adding those extra long tail phrases onto web pages that already rank for those head terms. The second tool I have for you is Google Search Console. Yes, you've heard of this tool before, but very few people are using it. The reason I say Google Search Console is you don't want to just use it or log in every once in a while and have it tell you errors or notify you, hey, something's wrong with your site, or hey, we noticed way too many 404 error pages. Instead, you want to use it to A/B test your title tags. What you'll find is you already rank for certain terms, but if you perform a search on Google, and if 1,000 other people perform that same search, and everyone naturally clicks on the second listing instead of the first listing, what do you think that tells Google? That tells Google that, hey, this second listing is way more relevant, so let's move it from spot number 2 to spot number 1. You want to A/B test your title tags. Look at Google Search Console, look at the terms that are ranking on page 1, and see if those terms are in your title tag. If they are, great. If they're not, make sure you add them. It'll help you get more clicks. The next thing you need to do is make your title tags more appealing by using action words, verbs. This will all help you get more clicks. Also look at magazine articles. Magazines, or even the cover of a magazine, they typically have catchy titles. How to lose weight in 30 days. How to shed 5 pounds in 30 days. 101 ways to do yoga, you know, as an advanced person. I don't know, I'm making them up here. But you get the point. Look at magazines for inspiration. By making your headline more appealing, you'll get more clicks, and over time, you'll start moving up in the rankings. The third tool I have for you is Ahrefs. Out of all the paid marketing tools out there, Ahrefs is the number one tool I love using. Why is that? It tells you everyone who's linking to your competition. Ahrefs has this cool feature called Link Intersect. What it allows you to do is put in your 3 top competitors and see who's linking to them and who's not linking to you. Because with Ahrefs, you can put in the top 3 competitors plus your own domain name. This allows you to see someone who's linking to all 3 of your competitors, but not you. The reason this is cool is if someone is linking to multiple of your competitors, it tells you that that person is receptive to link building and linking out to other sites. You have a much better chance of getting that site to link back to you than a site that only links to one out of all your competitors. Because you know if they're only linking to one, they're probably not into linking out to other sites within your space. So use Ahrefs. Once you see a laundry list of all the sites that are linking to your competitors but not you, you can see in what context they're linking to your competitors. It could just be that they're linking to them because they have amazing blogs. Well, if you don't have a blog, that's what means that you should be creating one, and then you can reach out to those sites being like, hey, I noticed that you linked out to three of my competitors, X, Y, and Z. I actually also have a blog, and this is what we cover that they don't. Doing simple things like sending those kind of emails is a great way to generate more links. Now, I know I said this video just has three tools, but I thought it would be fun to include a fourth tool as a bonus. So as a bonus for you, check out subscribers. This isn't an SEO tool, but here's how to help you increase your rankings. Google is all about brand mentions these days. The bigger the brand, the higher the site usually ranks in Google. You want to build a brand, and you can figure out where your brand is by using Google Trends, typing in your name compared to the competition. It'll show you if you're climbing or decreasing. It's really hard to build a brand, but one thing that helps is having people see your site and your content multiple times. Have you heard of the rule of seven? I've talked about this in past videos, but when someone sees your brand seven times, they're much more likely to convert and build that connection with your brand and your website, whether it's personal or corporate. So by using subscribers, when people visit your website in their browser, they can instantly subscribe just through one click. They don't have to put in their email or anything. And then whenever you have a new product or service or new blog content, you can send out a blast, keep getting people back to your site, building that brand. So in the long run, your rankings are gonna climb. Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment if you have any questions, share the video, tell other people about it. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.